Congratulations to Dr. Jeff Murdock. He is a winner of the Grammy Music Educator of the Year Award. It was presented by the Recording Academy and Grammy Museum. It recognizes current educators who have made a significant and lasting contribution in the field of music education and who demonstrate a commitment to the broader cause of maintaining music education in schools. Not to mention, Dr. Murdock is a two-time graduate of Southern Miss to the top, and he joins us today on Good Things. Welcome, Dr. Murdock.
Hello, how are you today?
Southern Miss to the top. I am a two-time graduate as well, but not in music.
Listen, Southern Miss to the top. It doesn't matter what your major was.
That's awesome. I agree. Okay, set the stage for us, because it's awesome that you were chosen out of 10 finalists for the Grammy Music Educator of the Year. Were you virtual when you got the news? Did you get to be at the Grammys in person? How did you receive the big news?
So I got the news a little bit earlier because CBS came to town to do a piece on me and on the choir. So I knew about a week before everything was announced. But I received a phone call from Harvey Mason, the director of the Grammys, and that's how I found out.
That's pretty cool. Did you dance? Did you go into a little jig? Were you over the moon? And who was the first person you called?
You know, I was over the moon, and it was so interesting. When I received the phone call, it was about a one-minute phone call, and the first person I told was my wife, who immediately started crying. For me, it was all so surreal for me. I hadn't yet processed it well enough to begin singing or dancing or anything like that. I'm definitely doing a jig now, but it took a minute for all of that to sink in, to be sure.
Well, you definitely have a lot to dance and to sing about being the Grammy's Music Educator of the Year, Dr. Murdock. But I want to go back to, like, what inspired you to this profession, because you didn't take a job as a music educator knowing that you could win a Grammy one day. So what in the beginning led you to this field?
Absolutely. So I was born and raised in Biloxi, Mississippi. And in Biloxi, I was raised in a part of town that people, that people frown upon and that people look down on and those sorts of things, and kind of where folks assume that greatness doesn't come from there. But along the way, I had many mentors and many folks in my village who saw talent in me and who saw potential in me, who nurtured those skills and who reached out to me on a regular basis and who poured into me and created opportunities for me. And those folks who created opportunities for me were integral to my musical formation. And so the way that those folks, like Felicia Cooper at Nichols Middle School and Rachel Ernest at Biloxi High School and Bernard McDaniel, my piano teacher, the way those folks poured into me and made me the musician that I am now, I want to turn around and do that same thing for other students. And so I became really passionate about that and passionate about leveling the field in music education, because even when I finished at Southern Miss with my master's degree, I moved to Tennessee where I taught in an inner-city school, Title I school, largely free and reduced lunch. Most of those students looked like me and had lived experiences very similar to mine growing up, and I became passionate about ensuring that those students too had the same kind of opportunities that I had when I was a child. And so my mantra now is leveling the field in music education such that every student every day, no matter who they are, no matter where they're from, no matter what their socioeconomic status is, no matter any of those things, has access to high-quality music education every single day.
Because sadly, you're right, Dr. Murdock, sometimes when school districts are just going through tough financial times or whatever it may be, sometimes it's the arts that get cut first. And oftentimes that is one of the opportunities for them to find a voice or find a skill or find an outlet where they can thrive. And not everybody's going to make it to the Grammys, either as an educator or even as a performer or a musician. But what do you see in your students that music education can provide past just the pathway to, you know, fame as a full-time professional artist?
Well, you know, what's interesting about music, and it's cliche to say that music is a universal language, but in so many ways it is. And music transcends so many emotions and so many boundaries and so many other hang-ups. My experience in choir was that choir and music in general, band and so forth and so on, all of those things created a familial atmosphere for me. And so I find that students who struggle in math and science and various other things, maybe they have difficult home lives, maybe they have, maybe they're experiencing depression or some other kind of mental illness, and they find a home and a space, a safe space, in music classrooms every single day. There's been so many students that I've taught who said to me, Mr. Murdock or Dr. Murdock, I would have committed suicide if it wasn't for your class, if it wasn't for music. I would have dropped out of school if it wasn't for your class and it wasn't for music. And I think that many administrators and school districts and the like need to see the way in which music can really change students' lives. And not just, you know, the research out there says that students who perform in music or are engaged in music, they perform better in math and science and other areas of academia. And while that may be true, I think more than anything, giving a student or giving a learner an opportunity to have those experiences, those musical experiences, will allow them to open so many more doors and will potentially save a life.
Well, and it's right. I mean, it just gives kids a different opportunity, a different outlet. It's the less pressure than the math, the science, or, you know, the history type classes that they feel like maybe they never level up. When you come into an arts class, whether it's choir or music, you feel a little bit of less pressure because nobody's good at it sort of at first, and it's sort of just playing around with the instruments. But I'm curious, I know you're now at the college level at the U of A, Dr. Murdock, but did you ever spend time with maybe those high school students who come in and maybe do have that chip on their shoulder that this is just music class or don't take it seriously? As an educator, how do you get some students past that barrier of feeling awkward because they don't know how to do it, to sort of really allow music to open their hearts or minds to a different path?
Well, as a teacher, one of the things I've become most passionate about is culturally responsive pedagogy, which is taking students from where they are to where we all want to go together. And what that looks like is, you know, to steal a quote from the Bible, it means becoming all things to all people so that you might win some. So it means meeting a student where they are. If a student comes in and they have an interest in basketball or an interest in, you know, rap music or an interest in whatever, how do you take that thing that is their interest, and connect with that student such that you can use that same connection to build bridges into musical concepts? And I'm a firm believer that a musical concept can be taught using anything. And as long as you can get that student's trust and figure out how to do that and how to build that relationship, I think that the sky's the limit. I've had many students who've entered my classroom who didn't want to do it, or they had to take a fine arts credit or something like that, who've left my classroom. One student in particular comes to mind who never wanted to be in choir, who's now a music teacher, because of the experiences that they had. And I think it's all about building the relationship first, and then adding the content.
Well, Dr. Murdock, you probably have a lot of parents listening to Good Things today that probably have students in their house who love music or maybe quite yet haven't figured out how to channel that love of just streaming on their iPod or whatever it may be into something more productive. What would you say to them about, you know, thinking outside too, not just with sports, but also as choir within school, show choir, music, band, some of those other avenues? I know there's other types of choirs outside of school realms if a school doesn't offer it, as being an outlet for kids. So sometimes the music arts kind of get overlooked in that junior high or high school era.
Yeah, I think it's absolutely necessary. And, you know, I played sports a little bit in high school. I wasn't very good at them. And if it had not been for music, I would not be who I am today. And there are other students. There are many of the athletes out there in the NBA talk about how they were involved in choir and band. Steph Curry, all these folks, Shaquille O'Neal, all these folks were involved in some kind of music at some point. So I don't think the end-all be-all has to be sports. I think that there are some viable opportunities and careers even in music. Even if a student doesn't want to be a musician, a full-time musician or a teacher or anything like that, that music really unlocks doors and unlocks the creative side of the brain to create other ways of even solving the most analytical of problems using the other side of the brain. And so it just adds another tool, I think, to the tool chest for the students to creatively have a means to an end in problem-solving skills and math and science and in so many other fields.
Well, you are definitely an inspiration not only to students, but also to those that aspire to be maybe in the music field full time. Dr. Murdock, it's been a pleasure having you here on Good Things. Congratulations again. Is there anywhere where we can catch up with you online?
Yeah, you can find me on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram, all at J-A-L-L-E-N Murdock, J. Allen Murdock. That's my handle on everything, and my website even is jallenmurdock.com. So I'd love to hear from our listeners, and thank you so much for having me today.
We'll have you back. And so-